Welcome to I Am Your Target Demographic, and today we're looking at some examples of animal life that are classified as functionally extinct. First, we should define what functional extinction is. Definition 1, the species no longer plays an effective role in their ecosystem. An example of this could be something like a predator no longer having an impact on their prey, which could drastically impact the ecosystem. Or an insect species no longer effectively pollinating the way it should. Definition 2 is that they no longer have a viable population. Obvious cases of this might be where the species can't reproduce quickly enough to really repopulate. Less obvious cases might be where the population is small, and if they attempt to repopulate, the inbreeding will be catastrophic to the species' DNA. Now, for the case of this video, who makes this definition? Let me introduce the International Union for Conservation of Nature, or the IUCN. Founded in 1945, this is the leading authority on the topic of natural conservation, and publishes what's called the IUCN Red List of Threatened Species, which outlines and catalogs species and their statuses. Over 170 countries are involved in their efforts, with a headquarters in Switzerland. The animals that we're going to discuss today have been classified as functionally extinct by the IUCN. First on our list is the northern white rhinoceros, native to the northern grasslands of Africa. As of this recording in June 2024, there are only 2 living northern white rhinos left, and they're functionally extinct because these 2 are both female, mother and daughter. They're in the care of a zoo from the Czech Republic, but they're being watched over in Kenya, where they have a 24/7 armed guard detail. These rhinos have been poached to extinction for their horns, which poachers can sell for $50,000 a pound in American currency. This greed has led to the decline of the population and now its eventual extinction. Now, there's some interesting science happening behind the scenes that may eventually be a hopeful sign. This decline was forecasted, and conservationists were able to secure frozen sperm from male white rhinos prior to their deaths. Eggs are also being cultivated from the surviving female rhinos, and they're hoping to create embryos through an in vitro fertilization similar to what humans go through, typically shortened to IVF. Successfully fertilized white rhino embryos could be transplanted into other species, like the southern white rhino, for surrogacy. So someday we may be able to see a slight and slow resurgence due to this technology. The next example is another species of rhinoceros, the Sumatran rhinoceros, specifically a subspecies called the Bornean rhinoceros. This is an incredibly small and hairy breed of rhino, more closely related to the ancient woolly rhino than any of its other rhino relatives alive today. This rhino's natural habitat is throughout Asia, formerly ranging across India, China, Vietnam, and other areas of Asia, whereas now it only exists in small pockets on the Indonesian islands of Borneo and Sumatra, hence the names. There are less than 80 of these rhinos alive, across multiple subspecies, and they've historically had a lot of difficulty in breeding programs, especially in captivity. They have been driven to near extinction also for the poaching of their horns, just as their African counterparts. Intense logging and deforestation also contribute to this. With the population so small, and the difficulties of breeding in captivity, the population has become small enough that it would lead to inbreeding and genetic inferiority over time, hence why they've been classified as functionally extinct. We now move into the waters of China to learn about the Baiji Dolphin. This species of dolphin that thrived in the Yangtze River of China hasn't been seen in 40 years and is possibly extinct, says the IUCN. This is the first dolphin to be made extinct due to the actions of man, as the rivers where they lived became highly used for fishing, transportation, and creation of hydroelectricity centers. In 2001, the Chinese government declared a national effort to save them, a little too late as they haven't been able to find any since. It is classified as functionally extinct because there have been local sightings, but never verified, and not at a rate that the population would be able to make a meaningful recovery, even if there were individuals still in the river. The Yangtze River's evolution has also caused other species to go extinct already, not just the Baiji. We now travel to the Gulf of California to meet the Vaquita, an incredibly small porpoise. It has an incredibly small range where they live in very shallow waters. This is a relatively new discovery. The Vaquita wasn't fully researched until the 1980s, but since then, they've been driven down to an approximated 9 to 11 individuals alive. Reproduction for the Vaquita is difficult, for they only birth a single calf every other year. They cannot reproduce fast enough to counteract the rate at which they're becoming extinct. Illegal fishing is the main cause for their decline, as vaquitas get entangled in the nets of fishers looking for other fish and shrimp in the area. There have been efforts to cease fishing in these areas, but not as aggressively as might be needed to save the vaquita from extinction. Back in China, we meet the South China tiger. This tiger is considered extinct in the wild, with no sightings of them in the wild since the 1980s. There have been unsubstantiated reports of prey killed by tigers, and things like scat and markings, so China declared an effort to work on their return to the wild. The latest captivity information is from 2019, where an estimated 150 South China tigers are in captivity, primarily in China. There's a few concerns for these tigers. Most prominently is the DNA degradation of inbreeding. So China has instituted a strict breeding record to track lineage. There's also a concern with species reintroduction, that most or all of its former natural habitat is unlikely to be able to sustain them. It may be too populated by humans, or might be lacking prey animals, for example. There is a test project in South Africa, where the Chinese are attempting to quote-unquote rewild the tigers in a place with adequate space and prey. There's also a reserve in China with hopes to rewild, but it is difficult. For now, this small and nearly extinct species is at a high risk. Let's discuss a bird on this list of the functionally extinct, the ivory-billed woodpecker. This is a woodpecker formerly native to the southern United States and even down into Cuba. The last substantiated sighting in the US was in 1944, and in Cuba in 1987, hence why there's no good video footage here. The American Birding Association has classified them as definitely or probably extinct. In terms of size, this was one of the largest woodpeckers in the world, and it's believed that hunting and extreme logging caused its habitat to disappear. There's documentation all the way back to the 1920s of people studying this bird and already contemplating its population decrease. As of 2024, it hasn't been officially declared extinct, but the United States Fish and Wildlife Service is preparing a final decision to be made soon, weighing in on all of the evidence. Over in Australia, let's visit Christmas Island, home of the Christmas Island Shrew. In general, Christmas Island has a lot of variety of wildlife, as it wasn't disturbed by humans for quite some time. Even today, 63% of the island is still a nature preserve, but that hasn't saved everything. Since human settlements appeared, many species have gone extinct from the island, partly due to the mining operations of the island's phosphate deposits. Many of these creatures were only found on Christmas Island and aren't found there anymore. The shrew hasn't been officially labeled as extinct, but the latest individual was found in 1985. Reasons for its decline include habitat loss, introduction of other predators such as cats, and the creation of roadways leading to road traffic deaths. There's also a non-native population of yellow crazy ants on Christmas Island, and this has become a super colony, and the government is trying to control this population, but the ants have devastated the local ecosystem, and this may have had an impact on the shrew population as well. I could do a whole video on the yellow crazy ants. Next up, let's discuss the Yangtze giant softshell turtle. Remember the Yangtze River in China? We're back, so let's look at this turtle, the largest freshwater turtle in the world. There are only two or three of these turtles still known to be alive, and they're unfortunately all female. All the males have died. Fertilization strategies were used prior to all the males disappearing, but all attempts failed. There are unsubstantiated reports of sightings throughout China and down to Vietnam, but nothing has been confirmed. In addition to the effects of the river, these turtles were also hunted for their meat and their shells and their bones to be used in alternative medicine. Last on our list is the Fernandina Island tortoise, a subspecies of the Galapagos tortoise. This specific subspecies was thought to be extinct already, until a single female was discovered on Fernandina Island, one of the Galapagos Islands outside of Ecuador. This has spurred many expeditions to attempt to find males of the same species for repopulation, or any other individuals in general. This one tortoise is already considered elderly, but we can hold out hope for a miracle. Now, this might be a somber ending to a video. These creatures are unfortunately in a very bad place, but education about animals and the effects of human actions on the world needs to start somewhere. Continue your research and do your part to create a more sustainable world. Look into ways that you can do that on a small scale. Consider donating your time or money to causes that are looking out for these at-risk animals. Going down this list has intrigued me to dig further, so you might see future videos about other animals and their stories, maybe even some that have seen success in repopulation efforts. Thank you for watching, and good luck in your journey to do your part.